children, welcome to our next online class. Our next chapter is plotting with pie plot. This is very important chapter. You will get question from this chapter, and we will write coding. You know how to draw graph, you know very well in graph paper, but now we have to do with coding. With the help of coding we will draw graph, we will write code according to that. So in this chapter I will tell you how to draw graph with the help of coding. Now our first topic is data visualization. Now what is data visualization? Now modern age has become very fast and competitive with the pace of the development in all the fields of life. Now we know that children, they in this modern age we all are very fast, lot of competitions are there in every field. We have to face competition in our life. So the reach of all businesses and facilities have gone global because of the modern technology. So this has made these things easier and competitive, but at the same time data have increased multifold. In fact, data had grown so big that a specific term has been coined, big data. So we know children that due to this modern technology, what everything is become easier, but what more competitive. You have to do face a lot of competition to success in your life or in any field. So for this easier and competitive, what we need, same time data have increased multifold. Okay, so now what the specific term has been came, that big data. Now but what is data? Let us see that. As you all are aware that the role of data is to empower decision makers to make decision based on facts, trends and statistical numbers available in the form of data. Data, we know that in SQL we know that we are filling a information of any person or any field, that is data. So here also the same thing, that the data is what, like a decision. Those who are taking decision according to the situation, you are also taking a decision. Like now here corona positive, now corona is there, so many are corona positive. So we are state government is taking a decision how to face this problem. So this is a fact, trend. Now in this here it is saying that fact, trend and statistical number. So when we will draw graph we need numbers, then only we can able to draw a graph. So that is a number available in the form of data. You will write code according to that data, you will give numbers, and that system will automatically create a graph in front of you. So but single data is a huge these days, that the decision makers must be able to sift through the unnecessary, unwanted data and get the right information presented in compact and app way, so that they can make the best decision. For this purpose, data visualization techniques have gained popularity. Confused, what is this data visualization? Now see, what is data visualization? Data visualization basically refers to the graphical or visual representation of information and data using visual elements like characters, charts, graphs and maps. You know from small classes that what is chart, what is graph and what is map, you know everything. So data visualization is immensely useful in decision making. Like you all are watching cricket, many times it has been shown the score with the help of graph, so that those who are seeing cricket match, they can understand when the person is out, when they got 4, when they got 6, how many are left. So we are getting they are telling with the help of graph. So we have seen how the data is created with in graph. So data visualization unveil patterns, trends, outliers, correlation, etc. in the data, and thereby helps decision makers understanding the mean of data to drive business decision. Very good example for this in share market also, they are showing that their data with the help of graph. so we can easily understand what when it is up and when it is going down. So up and downs are there in share market. So with the help of data, and they are using graph, so we can understand the things. Now, for instance, here example is given that a company has to decide about with advertising solution, should it invest into prompt its new product. Now, data visualization is help just pull out data of company's previous campaigns and plot a bar chart comparing the performance of different platforms. And bingo, the right decision is right in front. So in this chapter is dedicated to get you started with data visualization using Python useful module. Like pyplot is very useful to create a chart, any type of chart in Python, where you shall learn to represent data visually in various forms, such as there are so many types of graphs are there, like line, bar and pie chart, etc. So now let us start with pyplot. Using pyplot of matplotlib library. This is a library which you will write, then after this you will start writing program. So matplotlib is a library. Now for data visualization in Python, the matplotlib library is pyplot interface is used. Now the matplotlib is a Python library that provides many interfaces and functionality for 2D graph fix similar to MATLAB in various form. So this is a library where many interfaces and functionalities are there, which when you will write code, to run that code and draw graph, matplotlib library supports that. You can easily draw a 2D graphics. Now in short you can call matplotlib as a high quality plotting library of Python. This is a simple word that matplotlib, with the help of this you can easily plot library of Python. It provides both a very quick way to visual data from Python and publication quality figures in many formats. The matplotlib library offers many different named collections of methods. Now, pyplot is one such interface. This is an interface. Now, pyplot is what? Pyplot is a collection of methods with matplotlib, which allows user to construct 2D plots easily and interactively. So, pyplot essentially reproduces plotting functions and behavior of MATLAB. Now you have to install. Now how you will install this? You shall learn to plot data using pyplot, but before that make sure that matplotlib library should installed in your computer. Then only when you will enter data, your graph, your structure will be created. So if you are not you will not install matplotlib, then you will not get output. So if you have installed Python using Anaconda, you will use Anaconda here. Anaconda, then matplotlib library is already installed in your code. If you are installing Anaconda software, then automatically your matplotlib library will install. So no need to install separate. So you can check it yourself by Anaconda Navigator. This you have to install in your computer from Navigator window. Okay. So click environments and then scroll down in the alphabetically sorted list of installed package on your computer. Now you can find the matplotlib there. So once you will install the Anaconda Navigator, then you can check whether matplotlib is there or not. So you can easily see from where? From Navigator window, click environment and scroll, you will get the alphabetical shortlist of installed package on your computer. So there you can easily see the matplotlib is there. So if you have installed Python using standard official distribution, you may need to install matplotlib. Okay, apart from this, if you are not installing Anaconda Navigator, if you have installed Python, then you have to separately install matplotlib in your system, then it will work. So first, what you need to download wheel pack of matplotlib as per Python version, according to the version, okay, which Python you are using in your computer, according to that version you install matplotlib. You first you download the matplotlib and then you install in your computer. So on which it has been installed. So for this, here link is also given where you can easily find the matplotlib. Here for this you have to go this link, that https://pypi.org/project/matplotlib/#files, and download required wheel package as per your platform. So what next, you need to install it by giving following command. So this command also you can write in command prompt, like python-mpip install -upip. This is a command which you will write in command prompt. Command prompt is a black window screen you will get in your computer, that command prompt window. There you can write this code, then also you will get matplotlib. So MATLAB is a high performance language for technical computing. What it integrates computation, visualization and programming in a easy to use environment, where problems and solutions are expressed in familiar mathematical notation. So children, those who are having system in your home or laptop, you install Anaconda Navigator, or if you are already having Python, then you separately you install matplotlib. Then we can easily practice matplotlib in our computer. Those who are not having, you can come to school. I will tell you, if you can, then I will help you for this, and we will do project here only. Okay, thank you children. Rest we will see in next class.